Thank you for joining us for the May 2016 edition of The Salem Connection. I'm your host, Casey Duncan, and for the next few minutes, I'll be connecting you to what's happening in your community. Spring is in the air, and before you know it, summer will be here. Salem Parks would like to welcome you back to our community parks. We'd like to take this opportunity to remind everyone about some tips to preserve our public spaces as places of beauty and enjoyment for everyone. Dogs on leashes are welcome in all city parks. Most parks have mutt mitt dispensers so owners can pick up after a pet, which helps keep parks cleaner and safer for visitors. In off-leash areas, owners must be with their pets and in verbal control of their dogs at all times. As a reminder, on August 22nd last year, all Salem parks became smoke-free. City of Salem park facilities may provide the perfect option for a company picnic, family reunion, or other special event. For questions, please call 503-588-6261 or email parksandrecreation@cityofsalem.net. For more information about these topics or about park locations, hours and features like trail connections or splash fountains, please visit the Salem Parks section on our website. Volunteers make our work more valuable and help stretch the city's limited resources. In 2015, more than 6,500 residents contributed their time to our library, parks, recreation programs, streets, police, community emergency response efforts, and neighborhoods. Volunteers also support Salem's 20 advisory boards and commissions. As many as 190 individuals contribute their time, energy, and expertise in representing Salem's neighborhoods, area businesses, and social service organizations, and advising the Salem City Council and Urban Renewal Agency Board. For more on volunteer opportunities, which may fit your schedule, we turn to Karen Fisher, Tibby Larson, and Marilyn Daly. Tibby helps volunteers connect with opportunities in our parks. Karen with those interested in volunteering at Salem's Public Library. And Marilyn with those interested in volunteering at Salem Center 50+.
We have lots of events and activities where we regularly recruit volunteers for maybe one-time or two-time events. And we do that through our website and our volunteer orientations. Our Discovery Room is like a miniature children's museum. And so we need people who not only love children and love working with children and their caregivers, but also are willing to get down and really show children and their families how to interact with the hands-on learning exhibits. The other huge volunteer opportunity we have is Summer Reading Club is coming up, and we need adults and we need high school students and college-age students who are willing to give of their time to help us at our summer reading table. Kids will be coming in to sign up. They'll be coming in to turn in their hours. And we need people with friendly faces and lots of happy energy to help our children. And we have well over 6,000 children that join us every year.
We have all kinds of neat opportunities for individuals, families, service groups, churches. We have lots of events coming up. You can see those on our website. We also have all kinds of opportunities where people can work on their own schedule. A few scheduled opportunities, we have gardening at Deepwood on Monday mornings. We have gardening at Bush Park on Tuesday mornings. We have then on your own volunteer schedule, you can become a Minto Brown Park volunteer and patrol the park, get your exercise, and do that any 8 hours of the month that work for you. Paint fire hydrants when the sun is out. We have a whole number of opportunities, and you can see those all on our website. When you come to volunteer at a park event, you'll want to dress for the weather. Be sure to wear sturdy shoes. Sandals aren't a good idea when you're volunteering in a park. But the Salem Parks Department provides all the tools and the bark mulch and the paint and everything you need to volunteer.
At Center 50 Plus, we're all about helping connect those individuals age 50 and older to valuable programs, services, and connect to our community. Each and every area at Center 50 Plus utilizes a volunteer. So whether it's assisting with leading programming that's totally based on your personal interests, past careers, goals and desires, we can place you in those areas. But when you walk in the front door, we need receptionists. We need clerks in the boutique. We need assistance up in the lapidary and the wood shop and in all of our lifelong learning places. The dining room, I mean, it's just really endless. We have over 200 different programs and services, and we can link everyone to one of those great programs. But if we don't have something at Center 50 Plus that makes you excited, we also can connect you to volunteer opportunities throughout the community. We have groups that work in the schools, we have groups that work in the parks, we have our seniors everywhere in the community giving back, and we have places for you.
Interested in helping out at an upcoming running race or relay, a community event like the 4th of July celebration at Riverfront Park? Learn more about these opportunities and more at cityofsalem.net through the How Do I menu. For this edition, we are featuring three significant road construction projects in the community. Improvements to the intersection at 25th and Madrona, widening of Kubler and improving the Kubler intersection with Commercial, and adding bike lanes to High and Church Streets. We thank you for your patience as you travel through these and other construction project areas. These projects will help improve mobility and safety, traffic flow, and livability in Salem. In addition to providing community benefit, these projects also boost our local and regional economy. To date, local construction companies have performed 92% of the construction contracts awarded through the 2008 voter-approved Streets and Bridges bond. These initial sets of Streets and Bridges projects have been completed, and savings from them have helped stretch funding to include 20 more improvement projects. The intersection of 25th and Madrona will be closed to all traffic from June to October of this year to reduce the overall cost and duration of the project. In addition to Streets and Bridges bond savings, the project was awarded a $1 million grant from the State of Oregon's Immediate Opportunity Fund. The State of Oregon Immediate Opportunity Funding of $1 million was also made possible due to NORPAC's expansion improvements and the job growth created by those improvements. For more, we turn to Public Works Engineer Aaron Edelman.
We're doing this to improve safety and reduce congestion of the intersection at Madrona and 25th. Currently, it's a stop-controlled intersection, and there's a lot of driver confusion that occurs at the intersection. It's nearing its capacity. The improvement will construct a traffic signal that will help with the capacity in the future as the traffic continues to grow. When the project's complete, there'll be two lanes of travel lanes in each direction, new curbs and sidewalks on both sides. On the airport side of the project here along 25th, there'll be a multi-use path for pedestrians and bikes. There'll be a new traffic signal at the intersection. Down the roadways along Madrona, there'll be a new connection that will connect 22nd Street to Madrona. Starting June 1st, we'll be closing the intersection to do some improvements in the creek area to install the new box culvert. There's some large walls associated with that construction that occurs along the creek and along the roadway. By closing it, we're hoping to have it back open to traffic by October 31st of this year.
This spring and summer, Kubler Boulevard will be undergoing significant improvements to improve capacity and minimize travel delays through the intersection. To minimize the disruption, 27th Street between Kubler Boulevard and Boone Road will be closed to all traffic. For more, we turn to Public Works Engineer Gary Mizek.
You'll see more and more activity as the weather gets better. And the contractor is actually doing some work right now on the east side of Commercial Street to add some drainage improvements and some sidewalk widening improvements. What you'll see as we work on the project on Commercial Street, the curbs and sidewalks will both be pushed farther out from the center of the street to allow for the addition of the left turn lane at the intersection of Kubler. So the street will get a turn lane wider. Widening on Kubler actually starts just west of Commercial Street and will extend down to the current widening that ODOT is doing near the I-5 interchange. The widening further down is mainly to add an additional eastbound travel lane all the way through the corridor. We will also be adding various additional turn lanes at the intersections of Battle Creek and 27th Avenue. Throughout the construction area, we've already reduced the speed limit to 35 miles per hour. So there'll be you just need to drive a little slower. It'll be subject to some delays at times, There will be, on Commercial Street, the majority of the work will be done at night. So if there are closures of through lanes on Commercial Street, they will occur between the hours of 9 p.m. and 6 a.m. On Kubler Boulevard, the roadway will be narrowed down to one through lane in each direction along Kubler. Traffic will be pushed to the north side of the road to allow the widening on the south side, and it'll be completed in late November.
This summer, one vehicle lane on High and Church Streets between Ferry and Union will be converted into bike lanes. This short-term project was a recommendation of the Central Salem Mobility Study. The bike lane conversion project will improve circulation, access, and safety for people traveling to, through, and within Central Salem. Construction work will take place during the day and evening hours. For more, we turn to transportation planner Julie Warnicki.
People who are traveling through downtown this summer will notice that we are doing work on High and Church Streets. This project is to install bicycle lanes on both of these streets so that people who want to travel to and through downtown Salem by bicycle have a safe place to do that. In order to do the project, we will be changing the striping on the street and also some of the striping for the parking spaces. So you'll see that some parking spaces that are now angled, like the ones here, will become parallel, and the striping on some that are parallel will become angle. And we're doing that so that we can provide the best protection for our bicyclists using these new bike lanes. The bike lanes will have, they'll be separated, they'll have buffers on each side. To do this, we will be going from the current, we have three travel lanes for cars, we're going to be going down to two travel lanes for cars, so we have room for this bicycle facility. And this is something that our residents have been asking us for a long time. Bicycling into downtown Salem is something that's a little bit hard for people who are new to bicycling, so we're putting this facility in so that we can get more people out using our streets by bike. During construction, there will be some parking restrictions, so we'll be doing the construction block by block. So you'll see on one block for 24 to 48 hours, there'll be no parking on that block, and then we'll move on to the next block. And a lot of the striping work will get done at night, but we have to make sure that cars aren't parked in the parking spaces so we can do the work.
I'm Officer Renz. It is May, which is Bicycle Safety Month, and I'm here to give you a few tips on bicycle safety. Most important thing is to wear a helmet, even if you're not required to by law. It's always a good idea to protect your head in case of an accident. Another thing you want to do is to follow all traffic laws. You're required to by law. Another thing you should do is stay visible to drivers around you by wearing bright clothing, staying in areas where drivers are expecting bicyclists to be. This is going to allow drivers to see you and allow you to see them. Do things that are expected by other drivers and cyclists, such as signaling, letting others know what your intentions are, just like are required by a vehicle. Always make sure that you're making eye contact with drivers before you make a turn. Just because you're signaling doesn't mean that they see you. So if there's one thing I want you to remember, the more predictably you ride, the safer you are. Just go out, have fun, enjoy the weather, and be healthy. Stay safe.
That concludes this edition of our show. Have ideas for future shows? Get in touch with us at manager@cityofsalem.net or 503-540-2426. You can find us on Facebook and Twitter, or get your City News Weekly by signing up for our electronic newsletter on our news page at cityofsalem.net. Thank you for joining us. We look forward to connecting with you next time on The Salem Connection.